shop is like walking a tightrope. The manufacturer is stuck in the precarious position of balancing a reasonable price against solid specs. In the case of the Nitro 5, Acer gets some things right, like the good graphics performance, understated design and consistently cool temperatures. But missteps, or calculated choices, like weak speakers and short battery life keep the Nitro 5 from earning a higher score. Despite the explosive moniker, the Nitro 5 isn't going to turn many heads. Still, its black brushed aluminum lid with the glossy embedded Acer logo has a low-key appeal that's office friendly. The berry red hinge has a lovely pop of color, and the Nitro insignia engraved on the top is a nice touch. Those of us with oily hands will want to keep a cloth around, as the laptop tends to pick up any excess residue. The laptop's interior is made primarily of black plastic with candy red accents on the keys and touchpad. The power button has been incorporated into the function key row, which, along with the rest of the keyboard, resides in a slight recess in the deck. The Nitro 5 has enough ports to make it a serviceable gaming battle station. I was surprised to see a pair of USB 2.0 ports in this day and age, but there they were, sitting on the right side of the notebook with the headset jack and power port. On the left, you'll find a USB 3.0 port, a USB Type-C port, an HDMI 2.0, a Gigabit Ethernet, a Kensington lock and an SD card reader. The Nitro 5's 15.6-inch, 1920x1080 display is fairly bright, but the colors aren't as accurate as they could be. I immediately noticed the yellow tint while watching the Black Panther trailer that washed out many of the blues. However, details looked sharp, including the intricate scarring on Eric Killmonger's body and the texture in his jet black coat. That all made its way into my Hitman playthrough, causing the exquisite white walls of the Parisian mansion to look yellow with age. It also made the red carpet look darker than normal. The Nitro 5's panel can reproduce 68% of the sRGB spectrum. That matches the Legion Y520 in power 15T, and is just a bit short of the Inspiron 15, which netted 70%. One place the Nitro 5 really shines, literally, is display brightness. The notebook averaged 273 nits, surpassing the 247 nit category average. The Inspiron 15 came in a distant second at 233 nits, while the Legion Y520 notched 220 nits. The Power 15T was the dimmest with the dismal 173 nits.